Aren't we all just a boy named Charlie Brown? On today's episode of It's a Review Series, Charlie Brown. As I've alluded to many times before, this is one of my favorite Peanuts things, just period. So I've been very, very excitedly waiting to be able to tackle this movie. And let's get this out of the way. Is this the best movie ever? No. Is it even that good of a movie? Probably not. But that's what makes it truly great. Peanuts was so goddamn popular in the 60s that they somehow let a movie that looks like this onto the silver screen. And don't get me wrong, I love the way that Peanuts looks, but it's definitely not Disney quality animation in any regard. And the fact that it got a theatrical release, several theatrical releases, is mind-blowing to me. Now, other cooler people on YouTube have done videos about this movie, like Toonrific Tariq, and yeah, that video that he did was really, really good, and I probably can't make anything near as good, so I'm not going to try to make anything even like what he's doing. I'm just going to continue to do my normal stream of consciousness ramblings about the movies and the specials and everything, give you my opinion, because that's what you're here for. You're here for me. So you may think that if a 25-minute special has a hard time not being full of just filler, then an hour-and-a-half movie based on the Peanuts would either fail miserably even harder at not having filler, or would somehow have enough time to fully flesh out everything. Well, I can tell you with 100% confidence that it is the former. Now, it does. Weirdly enough, I don't think it ruins the movie or even makes it boring. It honestly is like makes it even more surreal that it ever got released in theaters. But this movie is so fucking full of filler, like just random scenes that pretty much contribute nothing to the overall story of the movie, but are just there because there's no way that they could have like stretched this out for an entire hour and a half. What is the premise though? Well, it's basically like a Shonen Sports Anime, but about spelling bees. Yeah, so it's like Haikyuu, but it's about a spelling bee, and it's about Charlie Brown working his way up the ranks, training. There's multiple training arcs that happen in this movie. It's amazing. I love it. It begins with a rather lengthy sequence of Charlie Brown sucking, and then Lucy insulting him by showing him literally a slideshow of everything wrong with him, which is just honestly the best part of the movie.
These slides will show your tendency toward fatness.
And just cements Lucy as my favorite character because she's so over-the-top extra horrible. Despite it being a movie, though, the premise is as simple as Charlie Brown gets into a spelling bee competition, works his way up the ranks, and then ends up failing right at the end. So, yeah, it's a pretty basic premise that they were able to decently stretch to an hour and a half, despite the, like, oh, here's a 5-minute montage of stuff that has nothing to do with the... Like, there's a scene where Schroeder is playing the piano, and it's just showing all this impressionist art and, like, pictures of, like, Bach and Beethoven and all that. Don't know why it's there. Actually, I do know why. It's because they didn't have enough animation to fill the whole movie. I will say, though, that despite the fact that the animation is still not quite Disney level, it does get a little bit of a bump. You know, it looks really nice compared to the rest of the stuff from the 60s, of course. And this is the last time that we get to hear the classic Charlie Brown voice, as he'll be replaced because, I don't know, the original kid became a meth head or whatever happened to him. He's living in a cave now. Despite me liking this movie so much, there really is not that much to say beyond, like, well, there's funny scenes, and then the premise is really good, and it's really fun to watch, like, them try to make a fucking spelling bee exciting. But yeah, I think that I'm gonna just have to cut to the chase here. The reason that this movie sticks out in so many people's minds, and mine included, and it's a big part of that video that I mentioned earlier, is that it just has, like, one of the best endings, one of the most perfect Peanuts endings of all time, probably. You have dejected Charlie Brown in his bed, just wallowing away in depression for days on end, and then Linus comes and confronts him, and asks him what's wrong. Charlie Brown is spilling his guts about all of his failures, but then Linus is able to turn it around. He's not a narc this time. He actually says something really insightful and something that really stuck with me the first time that I watched the movie, and it really did truly affect me. The idea that despite the fact that Charlie Brown screwed up so much and at such a crucial point, the world just kept on moving. It didn't matter that he screwed up. You see, like I said before, that football gag is the most important gag in Peanuts and probably comic history, in that it's just the perfect display of exactly what makes Charlie Brown so great, is that no matter how much of a fuck up he is and a gullible fool that gets in way over his head, he keeps trying, and no matter how many times he just sees that there are no results to his actions, he just keeps on putting in the work. You know, he just keeps on doing the next thing. He's like, okay, next time it'll work. Next time it'll work. Next time it'll work. And when he got to this point where he got so high on his own supply and then fell down so hard that he couldn't find a way to get up, one of his friends recognized this and helped him see his own mentality again. And I feel like the movie's so great because this is honestly like the first of all of the 60s stuff that is really about something specific to Peanuts. You know, like the Christmas special is about something, but it's not about something specific to Peanuts. It's just a Christmas special. But this one, it definitely feels like they finally took everything from the comics and condensed it into this one great movie. Does it have a lot of non-starter jokes? Does it have a lot of like filler scenes that go on for way too long? Does it have a lot of like cheap animation tricks? Yes, yes, all yes. But does not matter. This is like the perfect glacier embodiment of Peanuts, and I wouldn't have it any other way. You can watch this one on Hulu, so it's actually easy to fucking watch. You don't have to go to like Internet Archive and watch Japanese subtitled versions of it or whatever. You can just go on a normal streaming platform and watch it. I don't know, HBO Max or whatever, whoever owns Peanuts, I don't know. Somebody put all the Peanuts stuff on a streaming app, please. Why aren't they there? There's so little presence for them being released that it's gonna get harder and harder to actually find video footage of some of these specials as I go through the 70s and 80s. Either way, we're wrapping up with the 60s now, so next time we're going on to the 70s. But when we pick up again, it's gonna be with Played Again, Charlie Brown. And when we go on into the 70s, we're gonna meet new characters. You know, we're gonna flesh out some old characters. We're gonna leave some old characters behind, like Violet. Who gives a shit about Violet and Patty? We're going to leave them behind. We're going to get Marcy. She's great. And Played Again, Charlie Brown is about Lucy and Schroeder. So, thumbs up from me. Fuck yeah. See you there.